Hi, and welcome to the Rugged Rundown. And this week, what I want to do is give you a comparison of Getac's K120 fully rugged hybrid laptop versus the Panasonic Toughbook CF-33 fully rugged hybrid laptop. That's right, people. Getac and Panasonic both competing in this type of laptop. What is a hybrid laptop? Well, let's take a look real quick. I'm going to give you kind of a brief overview and a comparison in what I found. Basically, the Getac and the Toughbook are the same basic weights. If you look at size-wise, the Panasonic is just a tad smaller. If you look here, I'm going to show you the handles while we're comparing them. If we take a look at the handles, the Getac handle is a much bigger handle. And quite honestly, a better handle than the Panasonic. Panasonic is just a metal piece, whereas the Getac has this nice, softer feel to it. So it's, I feel like I could carry this longer without my hand hurting versus the Panasonic. Weight-wise, like I said, they're about the same. Now, there is a couple of differences. For example, on the Toughbook, you'll see the batteries are behind a door here, and here's the batteries. The one thing I don't like about the Toughbook is this door breaks. It's very flimsy and could break if you're not careful. So always be careful when opening it. Whereas the Getac, you don't have that problem. It feels like it's better made. To get to the batteries, I don't need to open up a door. Let me show you real quick. All I have to do is pop the lev and bingo, there's my battery. These are hot swappable, just like the Panasonic's. The other thing that I found out about these laptops, these two laptops, is the screens. The difference in screens. So let's take a look at that real quick. The Panasonic, let me open it up, there we go. They're both basically the same. The Getac is slightly bigger at 12.5 inches versus 11.6, I believe, on the Toughbook. But the resolution is what's different. The CF-33 has an oddball resolution of 1440 by 2160, which isn't standard. Whereas the Getac comes out with the standard 1920 by 1080p. So you have a 1080p screen versus not such a standard screen. So it can throw you off on your software whenever you load it in there. Not that it's bad, it's just different. I wanted to point those two things out. The other point that I want to make is the touchpads. I like the Getac's touchpad over the Panasonic. Panasonic's is kind of recessed into the palm rest, whereas the Getac is almost flush with the palm rest. I feel like it's easier to use. It's got bigger mouse buttons, almost by half an inch. I don't know if you guys can see that, but here's the mouse button here. And if we look at this one, you can see how the mouse buttons are slightly larger. That's a nice feature. The other thing that I will tell you is the keyboard. I really like the K120 keyboard. It feels so much better than the Panasonic's keyboard. Now, this isn't knocking either one of these units, so just keep that in mind. I'm just saying both of these units are great units. I'm just showing you the differences. And both keyboards are good. I just prefer the K120. It just has a nicer bounce to it. The keys feel like they're a little bit bigger, so my fingers fit on them slightly better. The keyboard even feels like it's wider. And that might be because the laptop itself is about a quarter inch wider, so the keyboard might be slightly bigger. I'm not sure. I didn't take a measuring tape to it. But basically, that's the differences in these units. They all have the same ports. That sort of thing. That's about it. They both have rear and front cameras. Panasonic's doesn't have a privacy shield, whereas the Getac does. Right here, you can see you have a privacy slide if you're worried about somebody watching you while you're working. I don't know. But overall, that's the differences in these two units. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching. You know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, like this video, and leave your comments below. I'll see you guys next week.